ديان يا رحمن يا ديان يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيهين عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا الحسن يا موسى بن جعفر أيها الكاظم إلهي بحق باب الحوائج اقضي حوائجنا حوائج الدنيا والآخرة يا الله يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيهين عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا الحسن يا علي بن موسى أيها الرضا إلهي بحق غريب الغرباء فك كل أسير وارجع كل غريب إلى وطنه يا رب يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيهين عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا جعفر يا محمد بن علي أيها التقي الجواد إلهي نسألك بجواد آل محمد أن تمن علينا من الرزق الحلال بجودك يا جواد يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيهين عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا الحسن يا علي بن محمد أيها الهادي التقي اللهم بحق الهادي اهدنا لكل ما يرضيك وجنبنا كل ما يعصيك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيهين عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا أبا محمد يا حسن بن علي أيها الزكي إلهي نسألك بظليمة العسكري أن تشبع كل جائع من جياع المسلمين وتنقذهم من سطوة السلاطين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيهين عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله يا وصي الحسن والخلف الحجة أيها القائم المنتظر اللهم عجل فرجه الشريف واجعلنا من أنصاره وأعوانه والمناصرين عن يا ابن رسول الله يا حجة الله على خلقه يا سيدنا ومولانا إنا توجهنا واستشفعنا وتوسلنا بك إلى الله وقدمناك بين يدي حاجاتنا يا وجيهين عند الله اشفع لنا عند الله أسأل الله سبحانه عز وجل ما يا الله give you whatever you want. Inshallah, he will give us everything. يا ساداتي وموالي إني توجهت بكم أئمتي وعدتي ليوم فقري وحاجتي إلى الله وتوسلت بكم إلى الله واستشفعت بكم إلى الله فاشفعوا لي عند الله واستنقذوني من ذنوبي عند الله فإنكم وسيلتي إلى الله وبحبكم وبقربكم أرجو نجاة من الله فكونوا عند الله رجائي يا سادتي يا أولياء الله صلى الله عليهم أجمعين ولعن الله أعداء الله ظالميهم من الأولين والآخرين آمين رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وآله أجمعين اللهم صل على محمد
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد حسن جزاك الله حج مندر for the recitation of the beautiful dua. Again, welcome everybody. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. After the beautiful recitation of dua, we'll welcome Haj Saeed Hazari, who is visiting from Florida. Assalamu alaikum, Haj Saeed.
Wa alaikum assalam.
So inshallah, we'll have the presentation by Haj Saeed on the dua, the weapon of a believer, the etiquettes, the manners, and the characteristics of the dua. We'll hear from Haj Saeed, inshallah. And Bismillah, Haj.
Haj, I'm going to share the screen. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء المرسلين سيدنا ومولانا حبيب قلوبنا أبي القاسم محمد
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه المجيد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله صدق الله العلي العظيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته
I like to thank Allah Azza wa Jal for allowing me this opportunity to share. Also, the board of IABAT, Karar, Brother Karar, Brother Mundir, and everyone, inshallah. What I'd like to do today, share with you a very important ibadah of a Muslim. One of the Imams of the Ahl al-Bayt defined this ibadah as one of the best worship for a Muslim, for a mu'min, for a muttaqi. So all levels of people can benefit from this element that is spread all over the Quran. Quran has over 200 ayahs in different format talking about dua. So inshallah today, I have put that into four different categories. Inshallah today, we'll look at the introduction to dua. What is it that we talk about dua? If a non-Muslim reaches me and say, you Muslim do dua, what is it? So I went searching and looking from Quran and Ahl al-Bayt. The second part is the manners and etiquettes, akhlaq and adab-e-dua, introduction to dua, manners and etiquettes of dua, and third, fundamentals of dua. There are certain rulings. And fourthly, inshallah, when I get into deeper research, the du'as of Anbiya or Mursaleen that are recorded in the Quran. And they are more than 200, inshallah. So we will begin with the first part, introduction to du'a. What you will see is accumulation of what I've been able to gather from scholars, reliable scholars, authentic scholars, books. Of course, the main source has been Quran. and Tafsir al-Quran written by valuable scholars. So importance and value of supplication for believers. I hope all of you can see the screens that I'm beginning to show. The very first part is definition of supplication, dua. And it is very important that each one of us try to go systematically. If you look at Quran and the rulings and the lessons of Quran, they're all systematic. They develop systems. They develop a sort of a ladder in which you can climb. And as you climb vertically, there's no limit. So dua is one of those tools that we can use in ascension, like Rasulullah went on Mi'raj. Our Mi'raj is starting with ibadah. Ibadah, best of form, one of the best form is dua. So definition of dua by different scholars. Then we get into Quranic verses, sayings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is Ahlul Bayt and Muslim scholars. And then we get into a little more base learning from Quran. So what is this relationship should be based on? Very simply, Quran puts it, the relationship between Allah as a creator and the creation, humans, is what? Best words can be described by the Quran. Nobody can replicate Quran. Quran is original, authentic, Kitab Allah, Lisan Allah. So now, what is this creator-creation relationship? All of us must understand. And it says very clearly in Surah Muhammad, Surah number 47, Ayah number 38, and it says, Wallahu al-ghani wa antum al-fuqara. There is only four words. Allah says, I am free of, I'm ghani. Allah, it does not need anything from anyone in any shape or form. Allah is free of need. He calls himself ghani. This is Asma al-Husna. Wallahu al-ghani wa antum al-fuqara. This is addressed to all the Muslims around the globe, regardless of color, creed, division, whatever it is. Quran is the work of Allah Azza wa Jal. When Allah says, I am ghani, and the reader and the believer and those who do shahada of Muhammad, Ali Muhammad, and then we say, okay, we are now going into the steps Allah has kept for it. I'm a faqir in the language of Allah Azza wa Jal. Or every Muslim, every mu'min, every human being, whether he accepts or not, he is faqir. And a definition of faqir is very difficult to say. One who needs air to live. If I don't get air for a minute or two, I'll die. Who's giving me this? Ghani is giving me this. I need water. I need food. I take everything for granted that it is there. There is a provider. There is a ghani. He says, if I hold the air from you, oxygen, you'll die. I'm ghani, you're faqir. You're faqir of air. You're faqir of water. You're faqir of food. You're faqir of hidayah. And above all, you're faqir to find my sirat mustaqim. And that's the journey we're going to take through dua. Then he says in Surah Mu'min, Surah number 40, Ayah number 60, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qala rabbuka ad'uni astajib lakum. These are very, very short ayah, four words. Qala rabbukum ad'uni astajib lakum. It is so powerful that it says, just call me. You don't need a cell phone. You don't need internet. You don't need a password. His password is Tamheed, Tamjeed, Hamd, Sana, Iman. That's what is what the calling card is. The greater the Iman, the better the call is. The better the line is. The better the synchronization is. So he says, call me. And there is no restriction. He did not restrict it to Muslim, Mu'min, Muttaqi, Iraqi, Irani, Pakistani, American. No, he says, call. Call. Whether you believe in me or not, I created you. I'll continue to be your creator. And I know you're faqir. So he says, just call and I'll fulfill your needs. With this beginning, this is Allah has given permission to call him. In all du'as, request is made to Allah alone. He is the only ghani. there is nobody on the earth in the creation that declares himself or herself to be free of need of Allah's lessons, Allah's ni'mah, Allah's barakah. So the request should be made to Allah Jalla Thana'uhu. And then he says, that Almighty has guaranteed responding to the pure and well-intended prayers of his servants. As we get into the introduction and other three parts, we'll realize the attributes we lack. At least I talk about myself. I will just stand there, oh Allah, remove this difficulty. Make my children healthy. Make somebody this, make somebody that. Don't make me poor. Don't get me caught with the coronavirus. Keep my wife, my children, my family, my friends safe. I have to go on seeking, searching. And he says, regardless of what your need is, قَالَ رَبُّكُمْ أَدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Inshallah, we'll continue. And has encouraged on making dua a daily activity that connects the needy servant to the perfect Lord, to whom everything is returned. There is no word to describe Allah's karama. The best way to do it is go through his Asma al-Husna. Through Asma al-Husna, we can recognize the attribute, the sifat, what Allah gives. Kareem, Hakim, Aleem. All these things are pointing to the perfect Lord we all have. Fortunate to have all these Lord. Then a believer must never dispense with dua. Must always direct all his feelings towards the Creator, asking for help and guidance. At this point, I would like to say that there is a Hadith Qudsi, and it is related to Musa ibn Imran, Nabi Allah, Rasul Allah, Abdullah, Kaleem Allah. He was told, Musa, ask me whatever you need, even if it's as small as a grain of salt. Ask me. And I remind myself that I look at a bigger picture and I forget the small things that he is providing me continuously, 24 hours. That's why Quran says, I shower my na'ma azbagun alaykum na'matahu zahiratan wa batinatan. Azbaga has been translated as I shower my na'ma. I shower my na'ma. Zahiratan wa batinatan. Known, seen, and then unseen. Inshallah, we continue. The Holy Quran and Prophet Muhammad and Ahl al-Bayt are the best source of learning. They're most purified. Purified in terms of Allah's message to all of us. So inshallah, we'll continue. And what I like to say at this point, some of the scholars have pointed out that there are three things identified in the Quran. Brothers and sisters, I share with you with deep passion because when you learn something valuable, you want to share it. The first thing you want to do is zakat of al-ilm, zakat of whatever tazki and nafs you learn, you want to pass it on. Because not only would you benefit, someone who uses it will benefit. As long as the person uses it, you continue to get benefit. If that person teaches to other person, they benefit. So three things identified in the Quran that take three things that take you into three other things. The very first thing they identify, and these are supported by ayahs of the Quran. Number one, ad-du'a l'ijaba. Ad-du'a l'ijaba. Du'a is always responded. Allah will not open the door of asking, seeking, supplicating, and closing the door. Allah never closes a door. The person asking does not understand the magnanimity of to whom he's asking, the etiquette, the manners, the fundamentals, the akhlaq. And if you read in the Quran, the way the anbiya mursaleen will do the dua, the humbleness, the khushu wa khudu, those are the etiquettes and the manners that we need to learn. So first thing is dua with ijaba. The second, shukr wa ziyada. If you're grateful, I said, I'll keep on giving you. Just be grateful to me. Me only. Ask me, I'll give you a response to you. Be grateful to me, I'll increase. In shakartum la azidannakum. If you're grateful, I'll go on increasing it. And lastly, tawakkal wa kafa billahi wakila. As soon as you reach that point of relying, Allah is a wakil. He says, I'm sufficient. So those of us, those fortunate ones, when you begin to reflect that in this matter, whatever the matter is, if you rely on Allah wholeheartedly, He will respond to you. And then you will know that He is sufficient. There are a lot of stories about these. Inshallah, I get into it. Time is short, material is a lot. So I'll continue with these thoughts. Remember, dua, ijaba, shukr wa ziyada, tawakkal wa kafaya. These are very, very important elements of dua. So now, definition. What do we understand? Dua is a simple acceptance of the difference between the existence of God and the human being. If we go back to the ayah from Surah Muhammad, Ya ayyunas antul faqara, you are faqir under every circumstance, from the time we are conceived in the mother's womb, it is through His will, through His ghina, that He has brought us into this world. So that this relationship has to be understood continuously until our last breath, and then continue into barzakh, and then continue to the Yawm al-Hashr. So it's a connector, the existence of Allah as the source of all good, perfection, independence, and bestowal. One who relies on Allah, he becomes istighna from human being. It's very difficult, extremely, extremely difficult. But we have to keep in mind where Allah is taking us. Allah is taking us, raising our level of faqir to closer and closer to ghani. Faqir to ghani, faqir to ghani. And He's the only one who can bestow perfection, independence, and bestowal. I think if I go to university, I'll become independent, maybe so. Or if I become a professional, or I become this, I become that. Unless Allah is called upon, if He agrees with our plans, intention, it perfection will not come. The existence of human being as a vessel of poverty, need, dependence on constant bestowal and favor, the human being needs to ask for and receive the favors of the Almighty. At the end of this page, I will slide. I'll tell you a couple of stories. The humans are in constant need for what only Allah can give. And believe me, in today's world, it is so evident, absolutely evident, that He is the only one who is inna Allah ala kulli shayin qadir. His qudra is on everything, whether the smallest or the biggest, the farthest or the closest. To help Him achieve His dreams. I have dreams. I'm sure all of you have some sort of dream. Those who have not gone for Hajj, they want to go for Hajj. That's a dream. Those who have not gone for Ziyarah, they want to go for Ziyarah. Those who have done certain other things, they want to do things fi sabilillah. And this is where Allah says, I will help you achieve your dreams. And there are a lot of stories that I don't want to for the sake of time. The second point is to give Him success and happiness in this world and the hereafter. This is important. When Allah gives, then you are a winner fit dunya wal akhirah. This is His guarantee that if you follow His command, if you follow His direction, if you follow His pattern, then you will win not in this world as well as in the second world. So make sure that you keep that in mind, that happiness, and it says in the Quran, that don't worry. I'll give you so much, so much, so much in the next life that you will be so pleased. So don't feel that you're left out here. Don't feel you're missing anything. As long as you are a good abd, as long as you're a good mu'min, as long as you follow the etiquettes, as long as you follow the fundamentals. So now, next point is, he needs the favors of Allah. We must keep this in mind. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, dua is the weapon of the believer. And this is a very, very popular hadith among all Muslims. This, what is this weapon that Rasulullah is talking about? A weapon to fend off all the intermediaries that are blocking us. And this is where something that a phrase out of Du'a-i Kumail that Imam Ali alayhi salam says, that kam min sanain jameeni lastu ahlan lahu nashrata. Oh Allah, how many of my beautiful things you have that I don't deserve, you put forward. Allahumma akfar li zanub allati tahbisu dua. Oh Allah, I pray, but there are so many sins I have committed or commit. I don't have the akhlaq, I don't have the adab, I don't have the fundamental. I'm still asking you, and yet, despite all those things that are blocking my dua, you're Rahman al-Rahim, you're Kareem, you're still listening to me. You're still going to give me. Dua is the weapon of the believer and the pillar of faith. This is very important to understand, that dua is considered to be, and this is Rasul Hadith, authentic Rasi Hadith, that the pillar of faith is dua. And the light of the heavens and the earth. I mean, you think of the attributes that are described by the most beloved and the most knowledgeable about Allah, Jalla Zikrahu, is none other than the last Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He teaches us through his Ahl al-Bayt, through Imam Ali, through Hassan, through Hussein, through Fatima al-Zahra salamu alayha, the how to stand. Their du'as are a light for us. And they are not just light for this earth, but they are light for the heavens. Know that he who owns the treasures of the skies and the earth has permitted you to pray to him. And this is something very important to understand. In the human world, you need permission. You need ijazah. You need appointment. You need. If you want to see a head of state today, it's not possible. No matter which country it is, it's not possible. Because you have to go through the whole process, the whole life, the whole line of questions, answers, purpose. He's too busy. And here's Allah, Jalla Zikrahu, he says, just call me. Just call me. Anyone personally calls him, he's available. And this is something, a very powerful element of Islam. And for a moment, and a Muslim. And has promised you acceptance of the prayer. He has commanded you to beg of him in order that he may give you. He wants to give us more and more and more and more. Take in the morning, afternoon, evening, family, life, health, education, whatever you need, come to me. But I will do my part. You have to do your part. And this is extremely important. We forget. And to seek his mercy in order that he may have mercy on you. And this is extremely important, that we benefit from his mercy. We benefit from his kindness, for his generosity. Ya ayyuhal insan, ma gharraka bi rabbikal kareem. What's wrong with you humans? I'm Kareem. And the definition of Asma al-Husna Kareem is so vast, you cannot describe. He's telling insan, what's wrong with you? I will take care of you. Why are you running away from me? He responds to you through the door of repentance. Tawbah, in a sense, means, oh Allah, protect me, I'm coming to you. It's like child returning to the mother. When the child is afraid, child is fearful, and does not know, feel defenseless, he looks for his mother. And this is what the repentance is, look for Allah. Allah says, I have left the door of repentance, come to Allah. Astaghfirullah Rabbi wa. I'm coming to you, Allah, cover me. I'm coming to you, Ya Allah, cover me. Therefore, whenever you call him, he hears your call. And this is the assurance we all must have. If he has told us to call, if he has showed us how to call, if he has showed us how to read Quran, how to read dua, then he will not deny us. He says, if you whisper deep down inside of you, and there are so many ayahs, at this point, I'll continue with this presentation. You place before him your needs. And no matter, like I said, the Hadith al-Qudsi of Musa alayhi salam. Musa ibn Imran, ask me. Even if it's a grain of salt. We think in our foolishness, it's too small. I'm asking too much. No, never too small, never too big. When does he say that you cannot call me in the morning, afternoon, evening, night? Call me while you're walking. Tell me while you're awake. Remember me, I'll remember. You remember me, I'll remember you. So remember him in your dua. Dua is a constant connection with Allah. Then he says, I will unveil before him the kind of things that he will put in front of us, we may not be able to handle. He looks at the capacity, the potential, what we're going to do with it. And sometime in his wisdom, He does not give us what will harm us. And there's a famous story of Musa killing Khidr alayhi salam, killing that boy. And when Musa asked him, why did you kill this boy? Because Allah gave him Khidr the Tawil, that in future this boy will grow up and will be a rebel towards his parents. And so the parents were good mu'min, mu'mina. So Allah thought this boy will be not pleasant for, so he took that boy away. And the story goes that he gave them a daughter through which 70 prophet lineage came. This is the gift Allah gives. Ghayr mamun. Okay, then you say, seek his help in your affairs and ask from the treasures of his mercy what no one also has the power to give. What are those things that he can give? So I need a loan, I go to the bank. I'm sick, so I go to a doctor. I have psychological problems, so I go to a psychiatrist. I need a dars, so I go to Hafiz al-Quran, and so forth and so on. But then long life, because the longer you live, the more chance you have of asking for his rahmah and ibadah. Then he says health of body. And this is important, that long life with health of body. Long life with mariz is going to be very, very difficult for an average person to handle. You have to be Nabi Allah, like Ayyub alayhi salam. After 70 years of his life, he enjoyed everything, and then suddenly Allah started taking one by one by one by one. And the last thing he inflicted him was his health. When he took away his possession, everything, his wealth, he says, okay, the last test is nafs. I'm going to test you with your body. And you know what? He never said anything ungrateful to Allah. When his wife tried to convince him that you need to do something, he said, why? For 70 years, I have enjoyed his karama, his rahmah, his barakah. So I cannot bear now for a short while what he is inflicting on me. An increase of livelihood of halal. This is extremely important, that we understand that these are the elements that we ask from Allah's treasure. Allah loves the believers who ask from him and supplicate constantly. And this is why if you look at the collection of dua of the Ahl al-Bayt, they are unbelievable, unbelievable. I mean, they will spend all night wrapped up in the Kaaba, the cloth of Kaaba. Fourth Imam, Sayyid al-Sajjad, will stand there all night crying, asking for forgiveness. Protect me, Ya Allah. Protect me, Ya Allah. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that on the Day of Judgment, two men with similar deeds will enter heaven. One of them will see that the other is granted a rank above him. So that he will ask Allah, my Lord, we have the same actions. Why have you preferred him over me? Allah will reply, he asked me and you did not. Don't contain yourself. Go on asking. His treasures never exhaust, no matter what we look for. Okay, so we continue, inshallah, definition. The Arabic word dua is very simply calling somebody. Request, speed dial. I mean, this kind of speed dialing, you cannot get it from the cell phone. No provider can give you this speed dial, because the greater the humility inside your heart, the greater will be the reward. At this point, I'll tell you a short story. There was a shopkeeper, and he was talking to his friend. A lady walks in. This lady looked very poor. From her clothes, she almost looked like a faqir, true faqir. So the storekeeper looked at her and ignored her. She came very quietly, subdued, as though she's hurting. She came close, and the shopkeeper kept talking to his friend, not paying attention. The friend said, lady, what is it you need? Well, he says, I need some groceries. So the shopkeeper says, do you have any money? I don't have any money, I'm faqir. Do you have any credit with us so that you can pay in the future? No, I don't have any credit. The shopkeeper says, well, I cannot give you open credit. You don't own anything. You don't have a bank account. You don't have a credit card. You don't have anything. How can I give you anything? She's a poor lady. So the shopkeeper's friend, he said, look, why don't you, I'll give you money, see what she needs. So shopkeeper say, okay, where is your list of things you need? He takes a list, a wrapped up paper, and puts it on one side of the scale. The scale goes down, and then he starts to poke, what do you need? I need this vegetable, I need this fruit, I need this vegetable, I need this fruit. And to the surprise of both the shopkeeper and his friend, the weight of the paper did not move. It stayed down, no matter what the other man put. But the shopkeeper kept putting on the one side more and more and more. It was full. Now, shopkeeper was totally astounded. He says, oh my God, what is it in this piece of paper? Anyways, the friend of the shopkeeper gave him, that said, here's my money. Here's $50. If she wants something more, give her. Shopkeeper says, I need to know, lady, please, what is in the note that is so heavy, it's not moving no matter what I put on the other side of the scale. He opened it and he was stunned. That was a plea, a dua of a poor lady, a faqir. She said, Ya Allah, you know my state of affairs. My husband is very sick. I cannot take him to the doctor. I don't have money. He does not earn anything now. I have several children. We don't have any money. We're hungry. My husband is ill. Where do I turn to, Ya Allah? I'm turning to you because you are the one and only provider I need. Ya Allah, Ya Allah. And then immediately the prayer was answered because she became a true faqir. So we continue now. It has been mentioned in Al-Mizan. This is one of the most reliable source for all Muslims. Tafsir al-Quran, Al-Mizan, by great scholar Tabatabai rahmatullah alayh. And he uses the method that Imam Ali has recommended, Tafsir al-Quran, Bil-Quran. And his tafasir is always answering one ayah with explaining from the other ayah. And this great scholar in his Tafsir al-Mizan, he says, supplication originates from the heart and is uttered by the tongue. It's important to understand what he's saying. Supplication starts from the heart. This is where I feel I need to learn. The initiation, the beginning, the pain, the suffering, the call begins from the heart. Supplication originates from the heart and is uttered by the tongue, one's nature. It is not the movement of the tongue, however, it is the specific features application under different situation depend on special motive which a user has in mind. So first thing all of us need to do, most importantly me, when I seek his help, I need to seek it from within my heart. Deep down, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, deep down. Keep on saying over and over and over and over again, Ya Allah, help me. And the deeper it is, the better it will be on my tongue. The best and most inclusive definition for supplication is asking in his broad and common sense. And I urge all of you, myself, that we make a habit from Fajr to Isha, and then next morning that we seek him. We go on seeking him and nobody else. We want to go to Ghani, the true, the real, the original Ghani. He's the only one who will give me relief from my tribulation. This is in Surah Furqan. This is a very interesting ayah. And Quran identifies that, look, قُلْ مَا يَعْبَأُ بِكِمْ رَبِّي لَوْلَا دُعَاءُكُمْ فَقَدْ كَذَّبْتُمْ فَسَوْفَ يَكُونُ لِزَامًا. This is the Furqan ayah number. Allah says, I don't care. You see, Allah is the creator. Those who do not believe in Allah, those who are mushrik, those who are kafir, those who are munkir, those who are munafiq. He said, I don't care if you don't ask me, but I'm your creator. I created you. I gave you the body. I gave you the mind. I gave you the ruh. I gave you everything. All your faculties, I own it. I'm the original owner. So in this ayah, Allah is this. He says, look, and he's addressing especially those who deny Allah's Jalla Zikra. He says, tell these people, my Lord would not care for you were it not for your prayer. And prayer is inside. Their lungs are seeking air, that's dua. The thirsty are seeking water in the desert, whether they believe in Allah or not, he's providing them water. The sick in all around the globe looking for some comfort. He's providing that for them because he is the creator. He's too magnanimous. Whether you ask him, you don't ask him, you ask him, you join the special category. And this is the dua, that this is ayah that defines very clearly that Allah says, I will go on helping you, even if you deny me. The Quran clearly points out to the fact that created beings, in order to satisfy and fulfill their needs and demands, have to turn to their Lord, who bestows his grace, blessings and bounties on them, corresponding to their sincerity. These two words are extremely important. Ikhlas wa taqwa. If he, a greater the ikhlas and taqwa, the greater you go to him and say, I know you will give me the best. I know. Go to Sabr Ayyub. He says, I enjoyed your bounties. I must now pass your test. Difficulty. That's okay. That was Imam Hussein alayhi salam. He says, I am here. I'm sincere. And I have only one purpose, to serve you, Ya Rab. That was his dua. There's no other Lord do I have. You are my only Lord there is. Allah turns to mercy to those who pray to him or call on him. And this is what you need, your sincerity and your taqwa. The greater the sincerity, the greater the taqwa. There is a narrative, one of these well-known scholars was talking about Musa alayhi salam again. Musa, give me gratitude. So he'll go into sajda. Again, he gets up. Musa, give me gratitude. Be in shukr to me. He does several times. And then when he was asked after, Musa, give me thanks. Ya Allah, how can I give you thanks? When the very thank, the attribute, the faculty, you're teaching me how to give thanks. He said, that's what I wanted to hear from you. I'm not being grateful. He's teaching me how to be grateful. That was something that I must do dua to. Inshallah, we'll continue. So the excellence of a man depends on the degree of sincerity and devotedness in his supplication to Allah. And the Quran confirms this in Surah Fatiha. 35:15, Ya ayyuhan nas antum ilallah wallahu al-ghaniyul. He's not only ghani, he said, I'm Hamid, praise me. He's added another word to his Asma'ul Husna. If you're faqir, then make sure you come to ghani, praising him. Ya Allah, how do I praise you? I cannot. You'll teach me how to praise you. So then we say every human being depends upon Allah's provisions. This is the permanent link between the creator, creation and the creator, that we do not forget him. If we after Salat al-Fajr through the Salat al-Zuhr, if I forget him, well, then I am the loser. You forget Allah, I forget Allah. During this time, I have to stay in touch with Allah. I have to keep my you know, what is it they call, the fast dial. I'm not very savvy with the cell phone. However, I have a mental cell phone. Every time I need it, I dial through my mind. I said, are you there? He said, yeah, I'm there. Are you there? He asked me. Well, I said, I was away. I've come back home. Ya Allah, cover me. Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, Rabbi wa tu. Cover me, Ya Allah. Protect me, Ya Allah. And this is supposed to be the last of this presentation of the first part. Allah Matabatawai Rahmatullah says, supplication is an electrical asking for divine assistance. People, you see, Allah is saying, use your intelligence. You're going to Hakim. He says, don't just stand there. Give me, give me, give me, give me, give me, give me. Give me with which you can be pleased with me. Ridan bi qada'i tasliman li amri. Ridan bi qada'i tasliman li amri. I want to find that dua that you'll be pleased with me, Ya Allah. That's all I want. I want to please you, Ya Allah. You are giving me all this faculty. You're giving me life. You're making me exist. Now make me worthwhile so I can please you, Ya Allah. Therefore, fasting is considered to be a very good way of asking Allah, a kind of asking for perfection, growth, and for Allah's favor. So after fasting of Ramadan, you have other recommended fasting that can be done. And fasting is a beautiful, beautiful way of going to Allah with a qalb salim. Because when you have settled down from food, from all the other necessities of life, then you are there. Ya Allah, I'm empty stomach. I'm thirsty, I'm hungry, I'm coming to you. Allah said, okay, now you're coming with a true heart. I'll give you something that will please you. And then Imam Zafar al-Sadiq salatullah salamu alayhi has said, often encourages his companion to ask from Allah. He once said to Maysar, his companion, O Maysar, supplicate and do not say the affair has been destined. And this is important, that he is the final judge, the ultimate. And he says in the Quran that whatever it is, I'm in control, absolute control. I'll give Adam, Hawa, life without father and mother. I'll give Isa, life without father. I'll give. So, O Maysar, supplicate and do not say the affair has been destined, because he is the ultimate to change the destiny. And this he has done for so many people. And you know the story of Uzair. Uzair was passing by and he saw this pillage and this town, bodies, dead bodies, rotting bodies, everything is destroyed. He said, Ya Allah, how are you going to give this place life? They're so dissipated, rotting bodies, animals, everything spread all over the village. And I said, okay, you want to know? He put him to sleep for 100 years. After 100 years, he replied, he said, get up. How long have you slept? How long did you go to sleep? Oh, a day, maybe a few hours. When he goes out, 100 years have gone by. This is what he can do. Surely there are ranks with Allah which cannot be reached except through asking. And this is extremely important. Utul ilma daraja. I'm going to give you knowledge, but with ilm. Seek his knowledge. That's the best dua you can have. Ya Allah, Rabbi zidni ilm. Rabbi zidni ilm. Rabbi zidni ilm. Give me ilm so I can serve you, Master. I can supplicate to you. I can do my duas properly. Okay. If the servant of Allah does his mouth, closes his mouth and does not ask, he will not be given anything. So ask and you will get. Oh, Maysar, the door that is knocked often is most likely to open. The more, day and night. Ask him. And ask him to what to ask also. Like I told you the story of Shukr from Musa alayhi salam. Dua is a great tool given to believers by Allah. Using dua, they can achieve great things and overcome many problems. One who has been given the power of dua never loses hope, as in his hand lies a great weapon. This is a very, very powerful quotation, that who has allowed you, don't worry about going to the White House or the Dark House, getting permissions. Go to the maker of the universe. He says, call me. Rabbak aduni astajib lakum. It is man's loss if he does not make use of the tremendous potential of dua. And I don't want to be a loser. Inshallah, I'd like to do this dua that we all pray that he keeps us safe in today's environment, all of us. And he gives us the tools to survive in this troubled time. Protect us from kufr, from shirk. Protect us from all the munafa. Protect us from the wrongdoings. Help us to become better mu'min. Help us to help other mu'min. And inshallah, Allah willing, and Brother Karar and Ibor, I have two other parts to this presentation. For the other one part is the etiquettes and manners, and the last part, fundamentals. Inshallah, at this point, I'm going to finish and I leave it open for question and answer. Please feel free to ask. Mehdi is sitting next to me. And if there are any questions of any kind, Dr. Karar, you seem to be a sort of put to sleep. Karar, I think I put you to sleep, did I?
No. Thank you, Saeed. Alhamdulillah, we'd like to hear you more. And again, you have divided this into four parts. That's good, though. So we know we can arrange three more sessions with you, and that way we can have you captured here in IABAT for those three more sessions. It's difficult to get you. If anybody has any questions to Haj Saeed on the
Halabi, welcome.
Topic related to the dua specifically, Please, you can open your mic and feel free to ask Hajj.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Hajj Saeed. This is Mazhar.
Wa alaikum assalam.
MashaAllah, it's so good to see you. And jazakumullah khairan that you have given us such a great presentation that I and my family enjoyed. And the question I have is that, inshallah, you said you have three more parts to this presentation, and I am sure you will maybe a part of the next presentation, maybe this is already being answered, but I'm going to ask you anyway. So far you haven't incorporated tawassul in the dua, and I was just wanting to know if it is coming up in the next presentations or not.
The part of tawassul will be connected to when I go into the fourth part, connecting with the Quran, because I prefer to give the language of Allah Azza wa Jal in Quran. I would like to go through that part, and one section in the last presentation will be tawassul. That the akhlaq, the adab, and who are the muqarrabun, they are the teachers. Inshallah, it's a very good question, and that really will be the answer in the final presentation.
Jazakallah khair, and I look forward to it, inshallah.
Inshallah. Inshallah. Okay. Anybody else? Wow. No? How about you, Brother Karar? Okay, it's possible to give the recording email to me. You want to answer that?
We are recording this session, if that's the question.
My mentor, Sheikh Al-Halabi.
He's gone.
Okay. Anyways, you know, like I said, it's great to see you all. And in this day and time, much more importantly, at other times, we need to connect with Quran, dua, supplications.
Hajj Saeed, I have a question. In the beginning of the presentation, you mentioned the dua is always answered. I think that's really concept to ponder. If you're saying, if Allah is saying, call me, I will answer you. So is it not possible for him to not answer? Now, the question is, when the answer comes, is what we have to understand. Yes. Is that my understanding, that it will be answered in one way or the other, when his, what he believes or what he thinks for you, the best?
I think the ayah, if you look at the ayah, it's not addressing specific. Ya alladhina amanu ya ayyuha, no. He says everybody. Qala rabbukum ud'uni astajib lakum. Everybody is calling intrinsically. When you acknowledge, then you become a mu'min. Then you have faith in him, then you become a mu'min. But everybody is seeking. Dua is seeking to go to the ultimate of this earth's life. For a moment, it continues into barzakh and on. He said, look, I am the creator, irregardless of whether you acknowledge me or not. I will continue to give you, I'll give you an example. I'll give you air to breathe, water to drink, food. It's equally divided. So his, yes, the question that you have said is yes. Now, the part that Akara that need to understand is, we have not understood, I talk about myself, the deeper a sense of dua, deeper a sense. What was Imam Ali's dua like? Imam Sajjad's dua was like? I would like to emulate that. I'd like to try and at least follow that route, that dua is not just ad hoc one time. We are needy 24/7. That's what he's saying. Period. You're faqir. You're just faqir. Now, the way the scholars describe, if the dua, Allah has said, I have opened the door, but you don't deserve my answer. Or the answer I'll give you, you're not suitable for it. His response is there. Sometimes the response is silence for the person of good of the person. People ask for things. And there are stories about that, that people ask, Allah gives them and they get doomed. So he gives it in the best form, best measure. He is Hakim. Time, place, and measure is perfect. To whom, to where, in what portion. And this is something that needs to be understood, is dua is a very deep intrinsic connection with Allah Azza wa Jalla 24/7. When you get hungry, well, I want to have best of food. And in a way, my fitrah is saying, Allah, give me hamburgers or whatever I need. But that's what the needs of faqir is. And that's a form of a dua. Any other question, Sheikhana, assalamu alaikum. Sheikh Al-Halabi. Sheikh Halabi.
Wa alaikum as-salam wa rahmatullah, brother.
How are you, everyone? Sheikh? How are you?
Alhamdulillah, I'm good.
Alhamdulillah.
I miss your presentation. I like it.
Alhamdulillah. Well, it's a good encouragement for me that you're there. And, you know, there's a saying, Mandar and Karar, that looking at father's face is an ibadah. Allahu Akbar.
Sure.
Yes. Of course, you have to be a worthy father, not Abu Jahal.
Father and mother, yes.
Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. And I'm saying that dua is a continuous connection. And it is considered to be one of the best forms of ibadah between Fajr and Dhuha, Dhuhr and Asr, Asr and Maghrib and Isha in the night.
Haji, I have one statement.
Yes.
The dua not always accepted because the reason is maybe the dua, what we ask is not good for us, so Allah don't give up to us. I do have a friend, he asked Allah to make him wealthy. When he become wealthy, he ain't went to jail. He said, I don't need anything anymore. So the dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know about us more than we know about ourselves. So correct. If he don't give us what we ask, it's not necessarily he did not answer our dua, but it's good for us. Because as Haji said, we don't know how to ask for what we need.
When Allah says, I will respond, sometimes response is silence.
Exactly.
No, response is silence.
Correct.
You see, we don't understand the depth of this word dua. Just because Allah held it because he wants to give me something better, it'll harm me. But that silence is a response. When he says, you respond, I'll answer. This is a very clear statement. His answer can be quiet. We deal with this every day with our children. Go away. Don't ask me these questions. Go to your room. This is not suitable for you to do this. I mean, you know, we do it all the time. So his method, the concept and the depth of dua is very vast, extremely vast. And that's what I'm trying to understand from Quran and the Ahl al-Bayt, the vastness of this, you know, how do, you know, these people, and particularly Imam Ali and Imam Sajjad alayhi salam, how the dua, the manqaba they do, that's just dumbfounding, the words they use.
I guess Brother Rafil has a question to maybe to Haj Maidi or Haj Saeed. It says about something about the fidya for the missing of the fast. Haj Maidi, did you want to answer this or let Brother Aqil know later?
Well, in the presence of Samahat al-Sheikh al-Halabi, it is better I don't give an answer. We have Samahat al-Sheikh with us so he can answer. Otherwise, I will answer Aqil offline, inshallah. Aqil, you can send me a private message and then I will answer the question.
Can I add something for...
Thank you, Sheikh. I will. Thank
for
you.
For the dua.
Please, Sheikhana.
Yeah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Holy Quran in very beautiful ayah that إِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِ عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي. Yeah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned here that if my servant, they ask you about me, I am so close to them, and I answer their dua, just with two conditions. They have also to answer my call, and they have to believe in me. These two conditions is very important to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with these two conditions, will answer our dua.
Thank you, Shaykhana.
Jazakallah, Shaykh. Sorry.
Hayakumullah.
Any other questions before we end this session? Inshallah, with time permits and with the permission of Haj Saeed, we can continue the series, inshallah, Allah willing, in the future. We'll coordinate with Haj Saeed about, you know, the other parts of it when his availability is, inshallah.
May Allah accept your deed, inshallah, all of you.
Thank you, Haj.
Thank you, all of you, and I am really privileged, and I'd like to thank IABAT, Brother Karar, Munzer, Shaykhana, all of you, and every one of you is special. I'm part of the fuqara. I'm not faqih like all of you. So I'm seeking, and I hope that I'm able to communicate and share with you in the future as well. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam
wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you, Maulana. Thank you.